Hey everybody, and welcome to episode 42. Do things look a little weird around here? Because they probably do. Oh man, look how good that looks with just some of the wheat fully grown. You can really tell where I jump down a lot. Trample everything around here. How are you guys? We got different kind of episode today, and a lot to talk about, and something different to do. Not much building today. First thing that I want to talk about is things look different around here, right? That's because texture pack. Now, normally, those that you've watched me before know that I use the John Smith Legacy texture pack. I think it looks really nice. It's really pretty. It gives a nice dark medieval look. I might be doing away with it for a few reasons. The first reason, I'm just walking around while we talk, by the way. The first reason is this texture pack is more relatable. Everyone knows the vanilla texture pack. Even if you use a texture pack, you know this. Second, I think some people maybe get the impression that building in a prettier texture pack maybe takes away from a builder, from the skills of a builder. I think that one's up to debate or based on, you know, the individual. But I think there is some negative connotation coming with building in a texture pack. I do want to say that I think I plan on slightly altering the vanilla texture pack to what fits me better. So changing the color of wheat maybe not be so bright and green. Something that kind of, hello, computer? Yeah, though, texture pack, like a custom texture pack based on the vanilla game, based on these textures here and there, changing the hues and stuff, changing the texture, one or two textures, hello, like Spike. I know a few YouTubers that do it. Honestly, I would just take like B-Dub's texture pack, but I want to do my own thing. It is going to take some learning from me. The reason I said take someone else's texture pack is because it will take some learning from me. I've never really edited a texture pack like that or anything, so it'll be a learning experience. So here we are. I was planning on finishing this area in the John Smith texture pack. And I still might do that. Oh, I just restarted my computer. I'm pretty sure that you can hear those noises that aren't from Minecraft. I just restarted my computer and it's been on for a while, but things keep popping up still and making noise. So sorry, but there's little things like I like the way that this place looks in the default texture pack. I don't like birch. If I were to have done this in texture pack in the vanilla, I probably would have used oak for this shade and dark oak for the oak shades, because they're kind of in John Smith. They're kind of one shade darker type of deal. So this is way bright for what I had originally imagined. So whenever I return to this area, maybe I'll keep the John Smith texture pack. But in the next area that I'm planning on, I'm making plans for and everything, I definitely want vanilla. I want to go back to vanilla. And, you know, this place still looks good. Walking through here, I love it. I feel immersed. I like it. But anyways, onto what I've done. I think I've put more off-camera work into this episode than I've put into any other episode, and you're not even going to see it because it's not building. Let's take a run over to my supplies. So the first thing is, my next place I'm thinking is going to be big, like more less focused on a town and more focused on a giant building. There will be a town involved, but the building will be a large focal point, more so than our Farmers Guild over there. And I kind of want to throw in maybe some farms, do a little bit more redstone than I have here. It'll still be a building-focused LP, but I might throw in some stuff to make our life, some QOL, quality of life, I know that defeated the purpose of saying QOL, repeating quality of life. Just some stuff to help us out. And I've been working towards that. So the first thing is, I have 6 wither skeleton skulls. And you might see some other stuff that I'm going to talk about. But this wither skull, so I spent hours, a few nights in a row, trying to get those suckers. And at first I had a looting 2 sword. And now, looking up numbers online, using a looting 2 sword, you should have about a 4.5% chance of getting a wither skull. I killed about 100 withers and had gotten 1. Obviously, doing the math, I should have gotten 4 to 5. So I upgraded to this, a looting 3. Did a lot of level grinding and enchanting. And, I went back and I found 5 wither skulls and about 30 skeletons. So one of 2 things is happening. Either I was getting super unlucky, or one of 3 things maybe. Either I was getting super unlucky and then super lucky, or the values for how that is calculated has changed and the wiki isn't up to date. Or the third is there's a bug and it's not calculating them correctly. And it's not on purpose. So, who knows, but I do have the 6 wither skulls, and those are going to be used to get 2 beacons. Now, the other thing that I did after that, I have a lot of blocks here. I'm running out of diamonds, but I have a lot. I collected about 80 iron blocks today, and about half these gold blocks. This should be enough for a single beacon. I think I need more if I want a double wide beacon. I'm not entirely sure. I haven't done the math. But I want these to be in the middle of our jungle place. And I might even use them around here until we move, because we're not quite done around here. The other thing to notice, I have some potions on me. So you can probably guess what's going to happen. I am going to fight the Wither. You might have also noticed I don't have shaders on this episode, and I haven't been using them a ton recently. I might go in and out on them. I'm definitely not using them down here, because then we couldn't see anything. Now, I just walked into a little mining section that's hidden away next to my town. We are directly underneath my town right now. And I've created a backup of my world in case this goes terribly wrong, because there's a good chance that I die. And let's put these in our offhand. If I die and this thing gets loose in our town, I don't care if you call it cheating. I don't care what you call it. I'm reloading this. I don't want to mess around with that, so I probably shouldn't even be doing it here. Let's not drink that. I was hoping to not run into a cave here. Let's get some blocks. I'm gonna start digging and find a place to kill this thing. This seems like a pretty good spot. I'm pretty removed. I mean, I'm not like terribly far away, but it shouldn't like destroy our staircase. I don't think that we're pretty much right under. I think we're far enough away from it. So I'm just chunking out some area. Now, I got all these potions. I'm not sure if with the combat update, if they made the wither much harder. I really don't know what to expect. I've fought the wither before, and I've always fought it above ground, and it's easier underground where you can control it and make sure that it doesn't get away. And I never really used potions. Actually, I just realized I am not using the right armor set, so let me go get that. This is the armor set that we'll be using. This is just regular, like, whatever, iron armor, and then Depth Strider feather falling boots right there, which are getting very expensive to repair, by the way. I don't know how much longer I'm going to be able to keep repairing those, but these are protection 4, protection 4, Protection 4. Now, I don't remember. Oh, man. I'm so slow. I forgot how slow water is. I'm not sure, but I think that protections can max out on those Protection 4s. So if that's true, then I might have some wasteful enchantments. I'm not entirely sure how that works. Let's head back down. I'll show you exactly where this area is. It's coming back up. It's not as far removed as I thought it was. I'll probably destroy a little bit of my staircase, but that's okay. We've got a backup if this all goes terribly wrong. If it all goes terribly wrong, then this guy is going to have a path straight back to the surface. So that's exciting. Let's put this down. I hope I'm not getting the pattern right. It's been a really long time since I've done this. I do have 6 wither skulls on me for some reason. I'm not doing 2 of them at once. I might do 2 of them here if the first one goes really easy. But let's put 2 of them down. And then take our potions. That's instant health. I'm missing one here, I think. Regeneration. No, these are all instant health. So night vision, because they're going to knock out the torches. Oh, you know what? Shields. I totally forgot those are even in the game. All right, so the night vision potion. And that will last 8 minutes, so no worries there. Let's get that off. Let's get some blocks on just in case. The strength potion, how long does this last? 1.5 minutes, so that one we gotta make better use of. I don't know if we're gonna need that, but let's put it on. And then regeneration we'll use as this thing's starting up. And get this out of here. Yeah. Hello? Can I hit it yet? Oh, hello. Like, where'd he go? There he is. All right, so he's trying to run away, it seems. We're doing a lot of damage, and he seems to be doing... trying to keep my eyes on my health bar. Might have to take a potion here. Yep. Let's take a potion. We got him halfway down. Is he like the dragon? Do we have to hit him with the sword? I'm not sure how this works. My health, though. Oh gosh, get me out. Get me out. Let's heal up. Get this here. I should have brought more potions, probably. That nearly killed me. Uh-huh, let's get rid of the wither effect. Was that instant health I just had, or regeneration? Regeneration's running out, so let's use that again. And... where is he? Oh! My gosh. I don't know if you can just... keep arrowing him? Arrowing. Hello? This isn't doing anything, is it? Okay, let's get out. Let's get out. Okay, use this as a choke point. That's doing damage. Alright, I think I figured it out. I think you have to use a sword at this point. Right? Alright. Where'd it go? Where's the star? Isn't there, like, a chance that it can... No! Oh, no. Well, at least we're close. And at least he started going the other way. I didn't see the star, though. You guys probably did. Isn't there a chance that it actually blows it up, though? If it fires and then dies, probably, and then the shot lands? Let's get down there and see. Alright, there's a spider in there. Let's just get our sword. Oh, there's a lot of stuff in here. Oh no. Not the... I don't know what to do. These things are gonna blow everything up. All right, guys. Shameful moment of the episode. I can't do it. Oh, actually, looking back at it, it looks like I had just about everything. I think the creepers would have only blown up that shovel. What I was worried about, I sat there for 5 minutes thinking about what I could do. And what I thought what might happen was one creeper, blow up, and then the other creeper blow up after I got killed and then destroy everything. And sorry, I put too much work into this Nether Star to lose it over a creeper. Sorry. Bad. Side note, there's more gold for us to put in our beacon down here. Ooh. But yeah, wow. This armor wasn't that high to begin with. But it's almost broken. I'm almost scared to take another round on it. Cause we could lose our armor here, and then we'd really be in trouble. So I think I'm gonna save the next wither, maybe for off camera, and try not to be so cheaty about it. Hey, I killed the wither just fine. It wasn't the wither that was my problem, okay? besides, I think everything would have turned out all right if I just let them blow up now that I think about it, but there's a chance of something weird happening. Actually, now that I got that thing, I could set up a beacon. First of all, I should do the next one at nighttime. I can set up a beacon and have strength going for me, a strength buff. And then I bet we'd do some real damage then. I don't even have... This sword is sharpness 4. I could have done better. And now that I know that it seems like you have to hit it with a sword when it's at half health, kind of like the dragon, it's a little bit easier. I didn't even use a shield, did I? No, I did. I think, it just dawned on me that I don't even know how to make a beacon. Okay, so I need obsidian and glass. I have 2 obsidian. Oh, here we go. So it looks like, I looked online. There, no, not there. There. And a beacon. Wait, did I not have enough glass? Oops. Let's grab another glass then, huh? And a beacon. Yeah. Let's find a place for this baby to go. Let's also grab. I'm pretty sure we're going to need just about all those. We're going to be really low on iron after this, which stinks because I'm going to have to go on another mining trip. But I want this somewhere. This is going to be temporary. So let's put it underground. And as far as I know, nothing can interfere with these, the buffs on these, just how far away you are. So it doesn't matter where they are, as long as the beacon can shine through. So I think the range is long enough that really if we put it anywhere in here, like should we put it, is it too much to have it right here? For now, let's have it right here. So let's go down. I need more torches. Oh, it's here. Do we get anything? No, you have to put in iron if I remember right. How does this work? Huh. So, apparently, now you always get regeneration, right? No. Well, I gotta put in some iron. So let's get some of that. So I really want the speed boost here, and I want 2 of them at our next base, our next building site. 1 for jump speed and 1 for jump, or for speed and jump boost. So I guess I might as well also have the regeneration while I'm at it, since I'm going to have one this big. Otherwise, I think that you could just have 2 this size, and I pretty sure that I have enough. If I were to take this bomb row out, I think, is it only two rows? Yeah, that's like nothing at all. So if we wanted to, we could get by easily with both of those, but we wouldn't have the regeneration, which is nice. So I'm going to say, yeah. Do we have a boost? Speed? Aren't we supposed to get regeneration? I'm not sure how these work. Do you not get both? Now I get both? Are they both going to refresh, or do I have only regeneration and not speed? No, they're refreshing, so I've got both. So let's get out. I didn't actually make myself a way to get out. So, I brought some glass with to cover this up, and it's black. So, our beacon here is going to be black. Oop, oh man, that's my eyes. Yeah, that's very black. Actually, it hit me a few times. I want to see this regeneration. It didn't even damage me. I have my good armor on still. But look how fast we are. Are there different levels of speed? Now, do speed potions stack with this? I feel like I'm not going that fast. That was kind of disappointing. I thought it was supposed to be faster than this. Is it not? Huh. As the wise testificate once said. Huh. But it looks like I'm out of range now. So I could probably even move that thing closer this way. I was thinking I'd have it over there since I have more of my current building projects over there. So in the long run, it'll probably be better. Let's get this armor off. I'm going to have to repair it. I also got... Apparently, withers are a great source of mining stone. I have room in here. Which I'm always in need of. Wow, that's a lot more stone. It's the little things, really. I'm literally always in need of stone, it seems like. I'm always going down there and strip mining just for stone. Like, I don't care about the diamonds or the iron. Now I care about the iron, but usually I don't. I just want the stone. What am I looking for? Oh yeah, I won't put this away. And... gonna have to patch that up before my next round with the wither, but... And our beacon's also too far away for that one site to use the buff on, so maybe we start the fight next time closer. That's too black. I might find green or something, because that's like death is spill a portal into the... into hell, like not even the nether. The nether is a joke to this place, just black energy spewing out of it. Now that I've been running around without the buff, though, I feel it. I just felt like I've been watching Ethel recently, which is, you know, he's got these things all over the place, and maybe it's his field of view. Or can you even change your field of view? No. Details? No. Quality? No, I think it's a slider, isn't it? I'm not sure. Maybe I'm looking in the wrong place, but I always felt like he was going faster. Maybe it's because he's indoors. Because I do feel faster when I'm walking by stuff like this. See, now I feel fast. Going fast. And then where does it run out? And then here it ran out. So, what's the limit on the distance? Let's find out. A lot of this stuff, this is going to all be found online, by the way. But I want to know for my own. So it kicked in at about 26 or 25. We're pretty close to the zero on the x-axis. So as a range of, is it really only 37, 38, 37.5 or something like that? Like 3/8 of 100 is where I get that number, which is the only reason I could think that makes sense. That doesn't seem very far. I could have sworn that the bigger that it is, the higher the radius is. So that's another reason I want the full pyramid. Let me do some research. All right, I did some looking into it, and it should actually be 50. So that should put us at about 37 when it runs, negative 37 here when it runs out. Is it still refreshing? Yeah, okay. I thought it was closer than that. So we've got 50 blocks of range in a cube, I believe. So if I go this way, I can go 50 blocks from it this way and still get it. It's not like a circle radius. It's a squared radius, if that makes any trigonometrical sense. Bones. Hey, you know how I was needing so many bones? Yeah, I've got, like, I don't know where they are, but I've got, iron. I've got, like, 6 stacks of bones from killing wither skeletons. Not even joking. This place actually doesn't look half bad with the default texture pack. There are some changes I think I'll make to the texture pack if I keep doing this, and, you know, there's even some changes I would make, because now these walls are very flat seeming. The other birch texture is very dirty. There's like one board that's like dirtier, darker than all the others, and it gives a lot of depth. So maybe there's some room for improvement there. That'll be a learning process. I've never really done that before. But anyways, yeah, now that I think about it, if these have a radius of 50, I want my temple, I'm getting way too many hints. I don't really know what it's going to be. I wouldn't call it a temple anyway, so don't read too much into it. But my next place I want is probably going to have a larger radius than this. So maybe I just keep it in the center of where we're going, and then I deal with it. And just kind of have the nice effects when I'm nearby. Or I could have them, like, one on each edge of them. But then I'd have to have a lot more materials for the pyramids themselves. I'd have to, if I wanted to have one on each side, as in, like, 4, then that would be a lot of resources. I'd pretty much have to make an iron farm. Which, this is a building focusing, so if I did that, that'd be an off-camera type of thing. Probably. I don't know. Like, a farm here and there, I don't think anyone's going to complain about that, will they? I was trying to see if I could jump up there. If I had the jump boost, I definitely could, I bet. But anyways, we didn't do any building this episode, but I put about 6 hours into this episode, all in all, to get those wither skulls, and I'm going to fight that wither on my own time. Just because I need to do more repairs. I would have done it right there, right then and there, but I have to repair again because that armor is, I used it to fight wither skulls and there's not unbreaking on it. I've been going through enchantment books like crazy, and I don't know if they've changed the rate at which you get unbreaking books, but I can't find any. I've been wanting to put unbreaking on that armor, but that armor is almost gone now, so maybe I should just be enchanting more diamond armor, although I'm low on diamond along with iron and gold and everything else now. So anyways, guys, let me know what you think about texture packs, making my own. I'm definitely not the first one to do it. I've seen multiple guys take the vanilla texture pack and, like, you know, make crates out of crafting tables. Or I actually haven't seen that. That's an idea that I could do. Or changing the color of this. Because when you look at it, this is really, really freaking ugly. This green. I'd rather bring out more yellow and gold in it. More of a bronze look. Birch, I would change, I think. I would change some of the wool colors for sure. I hate the default orange. I would change this hay to look more like what we built it in, the John Smith texture pack. I'd maybe change gravel. Not sure. I'm not a huge fan of the gravel texture. Maybe the color of these doors and also birch doors. Of birch door over there. You can't see from here, but I think it's the ugliest thing in the world. Before we go, by the way, I'm going to show you over there. If you haven't seen, that house is like the outlier, and there's like a secret in it where there's drug use, basically. This door is hideous. Down here is the Lapis Lab, and it is where I did a lot of my brewing here. See? A lot of my stuff that I got here. A few gas tiers I have left over from being in the Nether. But this is where the guy does drugs. Apparently, I guess. Apparently I'm that guy. Ugh. Anyways, guys, thanks for watching. Even though we didn't do any building, I thought it was exciting. It's a nice change of pace, honestly. I found putting 6 to 8 hours of grindy work into this stuff a lot easier than grinding out 6 to 8 hours of building. But if I could do that, man, that'd be a lot of building accomplished. Anyways, guys, thank you for watching. See you next time. Bye.